Good morning. Today we are going to discuss determination of index properties. Index properties, those are the properties of soil which are used in their classification and identification. Index properties are listed here. Those are water content, specific gravity, particle size distribution, consistency limits, in situ density and density index. Okay, we have to study the determination of these index properties. Now, we are going to discuss the determination of water content. There are mainly 7 methods for determination of water content. Those are oven drying method, sand bath method, alcohol method, calcium carbide method, picometer method, radiation method, and finally, torsion balance method. We have already studied three-phase system of soil. Soil is having three-phase system in which it consists of soil particles, air and water. The void space between the soil particles are filled with partly with air and partly with water. The engineering properties of the soil are strongly influenced by the amount of water present in it. So, we have necessarily calculated the water content amount, and it is useful in determination of bearing capacity and settlement of soil. And also, it gives an idea about the state of soil in the field. Water content is defined as the ratio of weight of water to weight of solids. It is always expressed as percentage. The experimental setup consists of various apparatus. Those are weighing balance, container, thermostatically controlled oven, desiccator, desiccating agent, and finally soil sample. Next is procedure. Take a container. Clean the container and lid. Lid is the top of the container. And weight. This weight is termed as W1. Okay, the second step is take the soil specimen from our sample and fill the container and take the weight with lid, and this weight is termed as W2. Okay, here a tabular column is given for taking the minimum quantity of soil sample. If soil is, that is 90% of soil is passing through 425 micron ISC, we are taken a minimum quantity of soil as 25 gram. If 90% of soil is passing through 2 mm ISC, we are taking a quantity of 50 gram. Okay, as like this. A sieve is a wired mesh. We can say aripa. Okay, next step is keep the container in the oven with lid removed, with top is removed, and maintain a temperature of 105 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius for 24 hours. For sandy soils, it takes 4 hours for complete drying, and in case of fat case, it takes 14 to 16 hours for complete drying. That is why we are taking roughly 24 hours. Okay, and if peat and organic matter is present in the soil, 60 degree Celsius is enough. And also, if gypsum is present in the soil sample, 80 degree Celsius is enough. If we are providing a temperature greater than 110 degree Celsius, it breaks the crystalline structure of clay. Clay, കളിമണ്ണിന്റെ ക്രിസ്റ്റലൈൻ സ്ട്രക്ചറിനെ ബ്രേക്ക് ചെയ്യും നമ്മൾ 110 ഡിഗ്രി സെൽഷ്യസിനേക്കാൾ കൂടുതൽ പ്രൊവൈഡ് ചെയ്യുകയാണെങ്കിൽ. സോ വി ആർ ടേക്കിംഗ് റഫ്ലി എ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ റേഞ്ച് ഓഫ് 105 ഡിഗ്രി സെൽഷ്യസ് ടു 110 degree Celsius. After 24 hours, take the container from the oven and take the constant weight, which is termed as W3. This is the weight of container plus dried soil sample. The weight is taken after the specimen is cooled. For that, we can use desiccator. When we place the sample in a desiccator, it is help to bring the temperature of our specimen into room temperature, and it also helps to avoid the absorption of atmosphere moisture. Repeat the experiment 2 more times and take the average. We are having the equation for water content determination, that is weight of water to weight of solids into 100. Weight of water is equal to W2 minus W3, and weight of solids equal to W3 minus W1. Here W1 is the weight of container plus lid. W2 is the weight of container plus lid plus wet soil. And W3 is the weight of container plus lid plus dry soil. Okay, thank you.